Good day to all of you. I hope you all remember all that was taught to you in yesterday's class. Today, you will learn something new. But before that, let us revise what we have learned earlier. Do you know why we use the character Meno? With the help of the character Meno, you can do all types of formatting on your text or paragraph which are available in the character Meno, like font name, font size, font color, bold, italics, underline, outline, shadow, etc. Can you tell what happens with indent and spacing? With indent and spacing, you can give space in your line or paragraph. Can you tell what happens with page background option? With the page background option, you can change the background of your page or slide. Can you tell what happens with change case? With change case option, you can change the case of the text or paragraph written by you to all capitals or all small, or you can apply sentence case or toggle case to your writing. Can you tell what happens with slide duplicate? With slide duplicate, you can copy any slide. The slide that you copy creates an exact similar slide to the original slide. Now, all of you switch on your computers and learn a new method to open your file. With the help of this video, let us learn to open the Impress file with a new method, which is a shortcut. For this, look for the Windows key on the keyboard, keep it pressed with the finger of your left hand, and then press the R button on the keyboard. The Run command box opens, and if you see something written in it, just press the backspace key to clear it. And then type S-Impress without leaving any spaces. S-I-M-P-R-E-S-S. After typing, click on the OK button. When you click, this box opens, which is the presentation wizard. Since we want an empty presentation, we should select that and then click on Create. And your Impress file gets opened. Let us begin today's class. In today's class, you will learn about the Tools Meno, the Slideshow Meno, and the Window Meno. You will learn about why we use spelling option, why we use gallery, how do we see a slide in the big screen, why do we use slideshow setting, what happens with custom animation? How do we hide a slide? How do we bring up a new window? How do we close a window? Have you all been able to open your file? If not, then again watch the video and learn. Now, all of you will insert 5 slides and do different types of work on each of them. In the first slide, type 5 lines about yourself. If you want, you can change the design of the slide. If you face any problems, then watch the video. Let us now see how we will create a presentation and write about ourselves in these slides. So firstly, let's insert five blank slides here. So to do that, click on the slide pane and then click on new slide. Since we want to change it to title slide, click on the title layout in the slide layout. Like this, keep getting new slides and keep changing them to title slide layout. This way we get 5 slides. with the title layout. Now, since we want to type about ourselves in the first slide, click on the first slide in the slide pane so that you have the first slide here. Then where it says title, click there. And since we are going to write about ourselves, let us give a title about myself. As is being shown in the video, we write the title about myself. Now click in the slide area where it says click to add text, and then you can start typing about yourself. So let's first type our name. Like in this slide, we are showing you it says my name is Deepak. You can type your own name there. Put a full stop and then press the enter key to go to the next line. Let's write about our age. So we can say I am 15 years old. As you can see in the video also, after that, let's put a full stop once again to go to the new line. Press the enter key on the keyboard. Let us now type about which school we are studying in. So in my case, we are writing my school's name is Computer Shiksha. So you also in your own slide can type about your school's name. Computer Shiksha. After that, we put a full stop and press enter to come to the new line. And then we can write about our hobby. So this way we can write about ourselves. So in this case, we are typing, I like to play cricket. Put a full stop. So this way we have written about myself. Now we need to also change the slide design. So you all know, to change the slide design, we need to use the format menu. So bring your pointer to the format menu in the menu bar, as is being shown in the video. Left click on that, and then from the sub menus which are available to you, choose the slide design sub menu. Click on that, a box opens, and then you can click on load so that you can see different kinds of templates available. My templates, presentation background, presentations. So here two are visible, but in your computer many would be available. So we can click on the one which we like and we can see the preview of the type of slide we'll get. Then we click on OK. It shows in the box and we select the one which we want and then we click on OK. So this slide design gets applied to the slide that we had made about myself. So this is how we can keen about ourselves and then change the slide design. In the next slide, insert any picture you like. If you face any problems, then watch the video. Let us next see how we can insert a picture on our slide in this Impress presentation. So let's select the second slide so that we can insert a picture. But this is a title slide. So let's change this to a blank layout because we want to insert a picture in a blank layout. So go to the slide layouts and select on blank slide layout. So it becomes a blank slide. Now to insert a picture, as you all know, we need to take the pointer to the insert option of the menu bar. Left click on that. And then from the submenus which open, bring your pointer to the picture submenu. As soon as you bring there, you see two options, from file or scan. Since we want to insert the picture from our file, we will select from file and you will see that a box opens wherein you can directly see some pictures, or if you know that you have already saved a picture in another location, then you can open that location. For instance, if you want to take a picture from the desktop, you will click on desktop, or if it is in documents, you will click on documents. Since our picture is available in the pictures location, we select that, click on sample pictures, and then click a picture which we like. To choose that, click on that and then click on open. So as soon as we click on open, you will see that this picture gets inserted into the second slide. The picture has green dots on its sides. Using these dots, when you click on them with the left button, keep it pressed and then move it up or down, and you can use that to resize the picture or to have it in different sizes. And if you click on the picture and then drag, you can drag the picture to wherever you like to keep it, and you can place it there. This is how you can insert a picture in your slide presentation. When you click on the side, the dots will go away. In the next slide, type about your school or about your teacher. And in the next slide, draw any image that you like and write one line about it. Leave the last slide blank. Have you all been able to make the slides using the method taught to you? If not, then take the help of the video to learn again. Let us now start learning about tools menu. The first option is of spelling. Can you tell why we use the spelling option? With the spelling option, you can check the spelling of your text. If you have used the wrong spelling for any word, then you can correct the same with the spelling option. Let us watch the video and see how this option is used. With the help of this video, we will now learn how we can use the spell check to check the spelling of our text. So in this presentation, let's first select a new slide so that we can type something. And we have selected this third slide now, and let's give it a title. Remember, we are trying to type something wrong, some wrong spellings, so that we can correct them later. So let's try and type about myself. Instead of typing A-B-O-U-T, we have just typed A-B-O-T. So we've made a mistake here purposefully. And again, myself, we are just typing M-Y-S-E-L and not M-Y-S-E-L-F. Then in the main body of the slide, let's type about ourselves, my name, and let's type the wrong spelling for name. Instead of N-A-M-E, we are just typing N-A-M is Deepak. Remember, Deepak is actually a Hindi word which has been typed in English. The computer will not be able to recognize a Hindi word. After typing the name, we press enter to go to the next line. And again, we are typing the wrong spelling for school. S-C-H-O-L instead of S-C-H-O-O-L. And name also, we have again typed it wrongly. Even computer, we have typed wrongly. So you will be able to see that whichever words are wrongly spelled and the computer cannot recognize them, they get underlined with this red curved line. So you can see the red curved line below the spellings which the computer is not able to recognize. Now to check these spellings, bring the cursor to the word about, and then you can select that and take the pointer to Tools menu and click on Spell Check, the first option here. You can also use the shortcut command F7 for this. When you click there, a box opens which is giving you the spelling in English. You can notice that in the box within it, you can see the sentence about myself, and about is it's in red, showing that it's a wrong spelling. And down below you have many suggestions. So look for the word which you think is the right word, about, A-B-O-U-T, and then click on change. So that gets changed here, and the next word which is wrongly spelled gets highlighted in red, myself. And the suggestions are showing the spelling. So click on the right word which you think is right, M-Y-S-E-L-F, and then again click on change. As soon as you click on change, a box appears saying that the spell check has completed this document. Actually, it has completed the title portion of the slide. And now when you click OK, you will see that the correct spelling has been applied to your title part. About myself has been typed correctly. Now, bring the pointer to the main portion of the slide, where again there are many spellings which are wrong. Click there so that the pointer is flashing there. And then again take your pointer to Tools menu in the menu bar. Left click on that, click on Spell Check. And then again you can see in the sentence which is highlighted, NAM is in red. So there is something wrong with the spelling. And in the suggestions, you can see there are various options shown. Since you know that you were trying to type name, look for the correct word which is in the end, N-A-M-E. Select that and then click on change. So the correct spelling of name, N-A-M-E, will get typed instead of the wrong spelling. As soon as you click on change, now it is showing Deepak, also to be a word in red. This is because it's not recognizing this. So now we know that the computer is not able to recognize this. So we just click on ignore once. So this particular word, it will ignore right now. And then the next sentence appears. School, S-C-H-O-L is the wrong spelling. So it is in red. So once again, there are suggestions here. You know that you were trying to type schools, S-C-H-O-O-L-S. You can click on that and then click on change. So that will get changed. And the next word which is wrong, which is N-A-M instead of N-A-M-E, appears in red. Again, there are suggestions here. You know that the correct one is N-A-M-E. Click on that, click on change, and it will get highlighted there in the correct way. The next word, computer, is also wrong, and it shows the suggestions. Click on the correct spelling and then click on change. So this way, spell check is helping you. Shiksha again is a Hindi word, so you have to just say ignore once. Click on ignore once. Now the box says spell check of the entire document has been completed. Just click on OK, and you see that in your slide, all the spellings, the mistakes that you had made, have got corrected. So this is how you can use spell check. The next option is of gallery. Can you tell what happens with the gallery option? With the help of gallery, you can get different types of graphics on your slide. By using the gallery, besides getting different images on your slide, you can also change the background of your slide. Let us see the video and understand how we use the gallery option. With the help of this video, we are now going to see how we use the gallery submenu of the tools menu. So first select a new slide, and then go to the slide layouts to make it a blank slide. So let's click a blank slide because we want to insert an image here. Now take your pointer to tools menu bar and click on the gallery option. When you click on the gallery option, you will see that a box opens which shows you various themes on the left side, And if you are looking at the first theme, which is arrows, on the right side, it shows you so many varieties of arrows. It also has these buttons here, which you can hide or show the gallery. So you have just clicked on the hide buttons. Now if you bring your pointer here, you can click again and it will get shown again. Now from the themes, you can select any of these themes. If you look at the arrows, there are many arrows already being shown here. If you scroll up and down, you can see many different varieties of arrows are available. So there are so many images available in just one theme, arrows. But there are many other themes like backgrounds, bullets, computers, diagrams, etc. So if you click on backgrounds, you will see that you can apply any of these backgrounds, and you can even scroll up or down to apply any of the other backgrounds which are available on your slide. Similarly, there is if there is a theme called bullets. So here you have many varieties of bullets. Next one shows you many varieties of computers. Then there are diagrams. You can select many images for diagrams that you want. And then there are themes of environment and finance, and many other topics are there. So you can, let's say, if you want to select one of these, let's say from computers, you click on computer theme and then left click on the computer image that you want. After left clicking, click with the right button and it shows two options, insert and preview. Since we want to insert this image, we will bring our pointer to insert. It has two options, copy. So since we want to copy it, we just click on copy and you can see that our image has come there. Now we can hide the gallery from these buttons, or we can even drag it up and down to resize the gallery portion and also our slide. So we click on the slide, the green buttons go away, we click on hide and the gallery gets hidden. So we can use this image like this. Now if we want to insert another image, you can use these green buttons to resize also, and you can use this toolbar here to crop the image or to change the outline of the image. Many things you can do with this. Now let's take another new slide and once again change this slide to a blank layout by clicking on the blank layout, and let's try and see another image insertion. So now since we already have, if we click on tools, the gallery is already there on our image. It has been hidden, so we just go to the show button here on top, click on that, left click, and the gallery gets shown to us, as you can see in the video. Now let's click on another theme. For instance, we click on a theme for backgrounds and then click on the background that we like, left click there, then right click on it, insert and preview. Since we want to insert, we just take our pointer there and then go to copy. Select the copy option and this image is copied on our slide. Now you see the green dots on the image. You can first hide the gallery by clicking on the hide buttons, and with these green dots, you can drag in any direction to resize the image. Like this, as is being shown in the video here for you, you can resize this image, and then when you click on the outside, the green dots disappear. So this is how you can use gallery and many images in your presentation. Let us now learn about the slideshow menu. The first option is of the slideshow option. Can you tell why we use the slideshow option? With the slideshow option, you can get to view the slide in a large screen. With this, your slide comes into a view where you can play all your slides and view them in a slideshow. let us watch the video and learn about using the slideshow option. With the help of this video, let us now learn how we can see our slides in a big screen in a slideshow. So first, you click on the slide from where you want to begin. So we can scroll up and click on the first slide as is being shown here. Now, take your pointer to the slideshow menu of the menu bar and click there. Left click, and from the options that open, you can click on the slideshow option. The shortcut command is F5 for slideshow. So once you click there, you will start seeing your slide in a large screen. So this is how you will see the slides in slideshow. To see the next slide, which is below your slide, you can use the down arrow key on the keyboard. So click on the down arrow key and the third slide is shown to you. Similarly, click once more on the down arrow key and the fourth slide or the last slide on your presentation is shown to you. If you want to see the slides above, you will click the up arrow. If you want to see the slides below, you will click the down arrow. Now, to come out of the slideshow, look for the escape button, the ESC button, which is on the top left corner of your keyboard. Click on that and you will be out of the slideshow. You can also see the slideshow from the view menu of the menu bar by clicking on slideshow in this option. So you can see the slideshow from the view menu or from slideshow or from with the help of the shortcut command F5. The next option is of slideshow setting. Can you tell why we use the slideshow setting? With slideshow setting, you can manage your slideshow, like defining with which slide to begin your slideshow. With these settings, you can set your slideshow to manual or automatic. Let us watch the video and learn about slideshow setting. With the help of this video, let us learn how we use the slideshow settings to run our slideshow. We can run it automatically or manually. So to do this, first take your pointer to the slideshow option in the menu bar, click on slideshow settings, and a box opens. In this box, you can first see the range, which means how many slides you want to see. So the first option is all slides. The second option defines from, which means that you can say from which slide you want to begin the slideshow. From the drop-down button here, you can select the slide where you want to begin. So for instance, if you want to begin with the third slide, we will click on slide 3 and click on OK. Now when we run the slideshow, our slideshow will begin from the third slide. As is being shown to you, we click on slideshow and you can see the third slide is what is shown to you first. Now you can use the down arrow or the up arrow to see the other slides. We press escape to come back. Again, click on slideshow and click on slideshow settings. Now let's see what happens with the type. We can select all slides or from. We'll select all slides here. And now let's look at the type that we want. This is the way that you want the slideshow to be run, by default, by window, or by auto. So in auto, you can set the time for which the slide will be visible in your slideshow. For instance, here we are keeping 005, which means for 5 seconds the slide will be visible and then the next slide will come. Click on OK. Now, after we click on OK, we go back to slideshow and start the slideshow. You will see all the slides. After every 5 seconds, the slide will change. So this is how the slides will change. As you can see, you can press escape and come back to the normal view of your Impress file. Next comes the option of custom animation. Do you know what happens with custom animation? With the custom animation option, you can get animation on your slide or object. This is a kind of effect. Custom animation offers you many different types of effects which you can use on your slides, text, image, drawing, etc. Let us watch this video and see how custom animation is used. With the help of this video, we will learn how we use custom animation to animate our slides in a slideshow. So first select the slide which you want to apply the custom animation. Then take your pointer to the slideshow option. Click on that, left click. And then click on the custom animation option. When you click there, on the right side of the slide, instead of the slide layout, you will get the custom animation box. So you can see there are many options available here, which are not highlighted right now. So when you click on, you can click on master animation page or custom animation. So we are on custom animation. Now, when we go to the slide area and click on the text on which we want to apply the custom animation, you will notice that as soon as we click here, the custom animation add option gets highlighted. So select the text that you want to apply the custom animation, come and click on add. When you click on add, a number of options for custom animation are available. There are entrance type custom animation, emphasis, something called exit. So these are different types of custom animation available. The next one is after exit, it's motion paths, and then there are some miscellaneous effects. So there is a whole variety of custom animations available. Let's use entrance for this first line or the title. So when you select any of these, you can scroll up and down and you will see that there are a very large number of custom animations available. So when you practice using these, you will know which one is the best for your use. For instance, if we apply the box effect and you notice that we have a automatic preview. So this, if you do not select automatic preview, it will not show on the slide. So when we select any of the custom animations, we should also have the automatic preview clicked upon or selected so that we can see the effect on our slide. The other option here is for speed. With how much speed you want to apply the custom animation. When you do the slideshow, should it come slowly or should it come very fast? So that way you can apply the speed also. So we can have very slow, slow, medium, fast, very fast. Any of these you can keep for applying the custom animation when you do the slideshow. So we are keeping it at slow. Now let's look at circle. If we click on circle, you notice that the title appears in that custom animation. So this is how you can check on different custom animations because the preview is available. You click on OK and you see in this preview window here in the custom animation area that this custom animation has got applied to the about myself text or the title. Now we click on the text area of the slide and let's select the first line because we want to now apply custom animation on the first line. After selecting, again take your pointer to add option in custom animation, left click on that, and from the box that opens, again you have many options available for applying custom animation. You can scroll up and down to see the other options. For instance, we are selecting wheel. And you can see the effect because automatic preview is already selected. You can select some exciting custom animations. This one is bounce. So your text comes with bounce. You click on OK. And in this small preview window in the custom animation, you will see that this line also is shown and the custom animation has got applied. We are selecting the next line now. As is being shown in the video, take the pointer again to the add option, click there, and let's apply a different custom animation now to this line, which means that we want to highlight this line, and we can select any of these like spin. So this line, when it gets applied in the slideshow, it will come with a spin. So click on OK, and this, you can see in the preview window, the third line is also has been applied with the custom animation. We go to the fourth line now. My school's name is Computer Shiksha. Select that. Click on add option with the pointer, left click. The box opens. And again, look for the animation that you want to apply. You can now try out the exit options for custom animation. And let's select, let's say, this one. Or flash once. We tried dissolve, we are now doing flash once, so the text will flash once. Or peek out. So these are different types of animations that you can apply, and because there is automatic preview, you can see what will happen with them. So we have applied spit animation and we click on OK, and you see that the fourth line also now appears in the preview window, meaning the custom animation has been applied to that line also. Now we are selecting the last line. I like to play cricket. Again, take the pointer to add option, left click on that, and from the custom animations which are available, we can just scroll up and down and choose whatever we like. So we are doing fold in the exciting category. So it animation has also been applied to the last line. So this way, if your lines are more, you can scroll up and down in the preview window. So this way you can apply animation to the text. You can also apply animation to your any object image or like a picture. So in the second slide we have selected, just click on the image so that the slide gets selected or the image gets selected. Click on add, and then from the box that opens, let's click on diamond to see the diamond effect, and you can see the preview on the slide. So this is how it will appear. We are clicking on OK, and you can see that for this slide, the custom animation has been applied on this image. It is shown in the preview window. Now to see how this custom animation will look in your slideshow, you can first click on the slide where you want to begin, and then come to slideshow option in the menu bar, left click on that, and click on slideshow. Or you can also use F5 as the shortcut command. So now you can see in the slide that the title slide is appearing with animation. My name is Deepak is appearing with animation. I am 15 years old because we had applied spin. So it is spinning. And in the next line we had asked for flash once. So it is flashing once. And then you can use the down arrow to see the next animation. So in each of these animations you need to click on down arrow. Now you can see that the image has come with the diamond kind of thing. This is how you will apply custom animation. The next option is of hide. Can you tell why we use the hide option? With the hide option, you can hide your slide. Select the slide that you want to hide and then select the hide option from the slideshow options, and your slide gets hidden. When you play the slideshow, then that slide will not appear in the slideshow. Now, all of you go ahead and show how you will hide a slide. If you have a doubt, then learn by watching the video. With this video, let us see what is the use of the hide slide option. If you do not want to show a slide, you can hide that with the hide slide. So if you click on the side pane and click on the side, there are three options: slideshow, hide slide, and duplicate slide. So you can click on the hide slide option here to hide this slide, or you can go to the menu bar and click on slideshow menu, and from there click on the hide slide option. As soon as you click on that, you will see in the side pane that particular slide gets hidden. Now if you were to run the slideshow, you will not be able to see this particular slide. Right now, since it was already selected in our slide, we can see the slide, but let's run the slideshow starting from slide 1. Click here and then click on slideshow option, and you can see the custom animations that we had applied appear. The next slide which appears is the third slide. You can see that the second slide which we had hidden has not been shown in the slideshow. So this way you can use this hide slide option to hide a slide that you don't want to show during the slideshow. So with the down arrow, we are only seeing the slides, other slides which were there. If you want to show this, click on it and you can see there is an option to show slide. So you can click on that and that slide will reappear in your slideshow. So this is how you use this option. Let us now learn about the window. The first option in window is of the new window. Can you tell what happens with the new window option? With the new window option, you can get a duplicate window for another file. Let us learn by watching the video. With the help of this video, let us now learn about the window menu of the menu bar. With window, you can open a new window and you can close the window. So to use this, take your pointer to the window option in the menu bar. Click on new window. You will notice in the title bar, you can see this file is now called Untitled 1.2, whereas your original file was Untitled 1. So this file is actually a copy of the original file. Now if you want to close this, you take the pointer back to window and you can see close window here, and you can also see both the files are being shown here, Untitled 1 and Untitled 1.2. Since the dot is on the Untitled 1.2, right now we have selected that file. So if we click on close window, this file, the Untitled 1.2, will get closed as is being shown in the video, and now you are back in your original file. You can see in the title bar it says Untitled 1. So this is how you can use the window option. Today's class ends here. All of you show how you will save your writer file in a different location and then properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you learned about some of the options of the tools menu, the slide menu, and the window menu. You learned about how do we see a slide in the big screen? Why do we use slideshow setting? What happens with custom animation? How do we hide a slide? How do we bring up a new window? How do we close a window? Thank you.